you guys. Good morning, good morning, good morning. As you can see for me, it's morning, 4:23. I had this crazy dream. It was so much going on in the dream at once. The first thing that stands out was, well, I don't want to say the entire dream. I'm just going to say the part that I think that matters the most. And the part that I think that matters the most, even though all of it is significant to me, but I think the part that I want to put out there, because it is important and it does pertain to, like, it's connected to, like, the world. Like, this is a very important spot, right? I'm just waking up, so give me a minute to shake it off. Sorry. So, as you can see, that place is called the Vatican. In my dream, I remember looking at, I don't know if I was watching a video, and the man was explaining that all of a sudden a woman named Celeste went missing. I remember him talking as if, like, now, is it a coincidence that this happened? And then Celeste, who is into Christianity, but her connection with, what do you say? Her connection with Christianity is actually, she's into the occult, like occultism or something like that. Like, it was something like that, child. It was something like that. I can't remember exactly what this man was saying, but it was like one of those videos on YouTube that you see when they speak about it in mystery, like it's so mysterious and they have the music behind it. I don't know. Oh God. So this woman named Celeste, I remember seeing her Facebook. I remember it said C and then the apostrophe E-L-S-T-E, I think, Celeste, that's how you spell it. I could not catch the last name. Oh my God. I could not. Now, if I would have caught that for some reason, oh my goodness, if I would have caught that last name and looked it up on Facebook and that's a real person. It was a Caucasian woman who you could look at her and tell she's into the occult. You could just look at her and tell. Like, I don't know. Like, it was someone that people followed. It's a woman. She's well known. She is someone that people follow. Like, they listened to her. So when she went missing, I don't know if it's because she recently exposed something about the Vatican, because I remember seeing the Pope. Oh God, it was weird. It was like in her picture, and it looked like the Pope or something behind her. Maybe it wasn't, I don't know. It was so, oh my God, it was distorted, but I remember seeing the Pope as if he was right in her background, right? So I was like, that's the Pope. Hold on, something about the Vatican. Something's going to come out about the Vatican. I don't know what it is. I have no clue what it is. The last time I remember hearing something about the Vatican was the closing of the Door of Mercy ceremony, because I had a vision in 2017. And I believe before that happened, and it was January 2017, so I think they had just done this ritual in 2016, like the end of 2016, closing that year out. And it was called the Closing of the Door of Mercy. And the vision that I had, it was, oh my God. And that was the first time, I believe, that I had a vision, open-eyed, I'm wide awake, I'm not sleeping. Well, I was kind of sleepy. I was in between state because I was at the office waiting for work, right? I was at the temp agency. This was when I was back in Atlanta and I was trying to just put things together and get things on track because I had just moved there. So I was like, okay. So I was kind of sleepy because I had to wake up super early that morning to get there to go to work, get some work. But I wasn't like sleep. And I just remember this vision rolled in. I was just like, damn, what is this? And good thing I didn't freak out. It was crazy because I could have freaked out, but I guess I was so calm and I understood what I was seeing. And when I understood the assignment, I said, oh, time to go. I swear, I didn't even stick around like I would normally do. Like all the way up until at least if you are still there at 8, 9 o'clock, ain't no work coming in. So it wasn't even nowhere near that. Like I had literally just got there. I probably been sitting there for about a good hour and a half. And that happened. And I just got up and I left because I was in awe. I was in awe. So, yeah, I do believe something's going to come out about the Vatican. Some woman named Celeste. The woman, her name is Celeste. The Vatican. And then in her house, I was able to catch some things about her house. And this woman had like, she was into the occult. I don't know if she was claiming to people, telling people she was a Christian or something like that. But she was very much so into the occult. So, yeah, Celeste, you ain't fooling nobody, girl. But I think it's funny because Celeste, right? We got the Vatican, a holy place. We got Celeste, like celestial. Something going on with the celestial in the heavens. I don't know. And then there is something about there was something about a blonde hair, blue eyed child. And I remember seeing they like showed a picture of him. And I don't know if she spoke out about him or I don't know if it was that she spoke out about him or I don't know. I don't know what it was about fully. I just know that this boy was highlighted in this picture. And I don't know. I really don't know. Blonde hair, blue eye. Who do we know that's blonde hair, blue eye? Then we talk about a woman named Celeste. Then we're talking about the Vatican. So I feel like something's going to come out in regards to the Vatican about celestial. I'm not about to do this. I'm not about to play. I feel like they have to come clean about celestial bodies and things like that and the truth about Jesus Christ. And the Vatican knows way more. They know so much more. They know the truth. Like the Vatican knows the truth. You hear me? And they have to start disclosing this stuff. This is what I'm getting. They are going to have to disclose a lot of this stuff. I don't know why. Come on now. A woman goes missing. So it was like when I think about a woman going missing named Celeste, Celestial, there's something, a piece of the pie that's missing. There's a piece of the puzzle that's missing about the celestial bodies and the truth about these different celestial forms that they're not telling us, but it's about to come to light because something is about to show up. Something's about to show up one way or another. Is going to show up. We're going to see. So we're going to see something. We're going to see something and it's going to like, oh my goodness. So, and it does have something to do with the truth about the blonde hair, blue eyed boy. I ain't going to call it. I'm not saying, Lord, forgive me. Like, I don't want to be disrespectful, but something about Jesus Christ, celestial beings and the truth, even about the makeup of our universe and how it really works and things like that. And I would look into it. I would do a reading on it to get more details. And I might just do a part two for that. But yeah, some stuff is going to come out either about the Vatican or some stuff is going to come out from the Vatican. Things will start being disclosed. You know, disclosure is happening. That's what I'm really picking that up heavily. And these are just some news articles. Also, with the Pope that was behind her in the photo or whatever it wasn't just him, it was like a group of them. It was like a group of them. And I want to say this too. For some reason, people keep saying E, Illu. They're like Illuminati, but it's really Ah Illuminati because they want to be exalted. I don't know what that's about, but yeah. So I don't know how they are connected with the Vatican. I don't know if there is a connection with them in the Vatican. I could be wrong. Those could be two totally different organizations, societies. Catch my drift, but yeah, I got that the other day and I didn't think it was needed to record it, but now I know why it came out. All right, y'all, I'm done rambling. That was the last little part, was like a bit of a ramble, just a bit. But it's I don't know. It's crazy. All right, y'all, until next time, peace.